You're not part of Europe unless you eat a cold breakfast.
You folks probably already know that I tour with Australia's Daniel Muggleton a lot. He's a super funny guy. Well, here's one of his clips.
Where are you from? Poland. Nice. All right, can I ask you a question? How many languages do you speak? Fucking only two. That's why you had to leave. Only two languages for a European. That is ridiculous, right? I cannot get over how many languages European people speak, man. And obviously, when I say European, I mean real. No, I mean real European. Like, as you get Irish people being like, we're part of Europe. No, you're fucking not, all right? You're not part of Europe unless you eat a cold breakfast. That's the rule. It's like, what'd you have for breakfast? Oh, yeah, I had a bowl of cereal and two slices of salami. Were there eggs? Yes, but they were cold before we ate them. That's Europe, right? Two languages, man. I can't get over how many languages European people speak, right? European people speak so many languages, they speak emergency Spanish. They're not from Spain, never been to Spain, don't plan on going. But they still learn Spanish just in case. European people speak Spanish just in case someone no habla. That's crazy, right? By the way, I did that joke one night, had a Polish lady say, actually, it's masculine, it's no hablo. And I was like, why the fuck do you speak Spanish, right? Why are you doing that? Why do you learn, you know? I'm Australian, I speak English and that's it, right? This is all I got. But I go to Europe and I get that guilt, right? I'm like, man, I should really learn a foreign language, you know? I should really do that shit. And then my plane touches back down in the UK and I'm like, nah. I already speak the important one. I fucking nailed it, right? I was born in an English-speaking country. English is the world language. I just get to sit back and enjoy it. While it lasts, obviously. I know it's not lasting forever, but at the moment, all the important shit's in English. Like, what language does subtitles come in? What language does the hostage read the message out in? Exactly. You've never seen a hostage video where the dude's like, je suis kidnapped, hasn't happened. It's an emergency, there's no time for French, right? You want to be understood. And like, I know it's not going to last, right? I know that. I know China's going to rise up, take over. But I promise you, when that happens, they're not going to tell us in Mandarin. They're going to tell us in English because they know if they don't, we'll be confused. We'll do what we always do when someone speaks a language we don't understand. Just smile and nod. Look, I'm so sorry, but I don't understand you. Do you speak English? And the Chinese guy will be like, yeah. That's why we won. A couple of people not laughing, being like, my Huawei phone is listening.
If you enjoyed Daniel, this weekend you can see him perform live at the Nowhere Comedy Club. It's a digital show with a real audience you can hear and be a part of. And every Saturday, Daniel and I host a show there together called Ask Us Anything, where the crowd gets involved. It's part game show, part stand-up comedy, and all hilarious. I'm also doing two full headlining shows there in June. You can get tickets to any of these shows at nowherecomedyclub.com, and I will see you nowhere soon.